Okay, hi. So I started Exodus 90 days before Easter, that's 6th of January. And before starting all this, I always thought, you know, when you have to be religious, prayerful, you can't live a normal life. Even Cedric Uncle brought it up earlier. So I'm guessing you all think the same, you know, when you want to be religious, you can't really live a normal life. But after doing these 90 days of Exodus, yes, your life is different from the other people who don't really do this or don't really live a prayerful life or don't keep God around. Your life is different from that, but that doesn't mean it's not normal. So for me, I had several disciplines, and the most difficult being a teenager is devices. I've struggled a lot with unnecessary device usage, and that was difficult because everything, our whole life is around that single mobile. Or if it is not mobile, I'll always be on my laptop. Not laptop, it's always something or the other. There's always devices around us to keep us occupied. So it was difficult. It took me about a good 3 to 4 weeks to reduce my screen time. I started with like 6 hours of screen time. And after 90 days, right now my screen time goes from 1 hour to 1.5 hour max. I had to stop watching movies, shows and all, which I personally like a lot. I had to do a lot of things and sweets. I used to wait every day for that one Sunday to go and have sweet, to go and have cake. I love cakes. I have a really big sweet too. So the whole thing, whole experience was kind of, how do I say? It's like you're letting go of control in your life. These devices stop controlling you altogether. Because what I personally notice is whenever you have a normal day, normal life, something you see in this device, that affects your day. That affects you for the rest of the day. You see something sad, or you see something, you know, unpleasant on a mobile device, that actually puts a toll on your head. And by the end of the day, you get extremely tired and drained. You don't have time for anyone, even including your family. It's very hard to have that energy for your family when you're in a device your whole day. So that letting go of the devices actually helped me spend a lot more time with myself, God, and especially my brothers. Because I was always packed with university or something or the other, and the rest of the time I spent on my devices. So from 6 hours going to 1 hour, yeah, I had 5 hours free.
That's really a good thing.
6 hours to 1 hour is awesome.
So I had like 5 hours to spare. I put that in sleep, I put that in that 1 hour I put for God. You know, we had 1 hour of prayer. I still couldn't finish 1 hour. Till 90 days, I was always at 30 minutes, 40 minutes. It was very hard to go 1 hour. My highest said it was around 50 minutes or so, but not more than that. And the whole meditation part is not easy. It's not easy at all. I found it really, really hard, and only after a good 50, 60 days I got it. But all I want to say is, altogether, you can be with God, you can put God as the center of your life and still live a normal life. And still live a life that you want, that you love. And as you start bringing God into your life, you start loving life more. You start looking at life in a different perspective. You'll stop require. It's sad, you know, at times when I started, I was like, you know, I have to give up my phone just for God. It's not that easy. It is really hard because, as I said, you know, everything is on our mobile, our games, our friends, everything. And it gets hard, but as you start letting go, you see the other parts of life that is outside your phone. You see your brothers or your siblings, you see your parents, you see your friends. And that really helped bring a new perspective in life. So personally, I say mobile was everything for me at one point, but after this, not having my mobile around me, in my pockets or in my hand 24/7, made life so much better. I highly recommend you all try it out as well. So yeah, life is much more free, and praise God for that.
Thank you so much.